Hello, Stryker.
Oh, well, hello, Professor. How are you today?
Oh, fine. What are you reading about?
The worst decision ever made by the Supreme Court?
Are you referring to the Dred Scott case?
Was it really?
What?
The worst decision?
Well, it might have been.
How did the Supreme Court mess it up?
Well, it's kind of a long story.
I got time.
All right, then. Let's begin.
Who is Dred Scott?
Well, he was a man who was born in Virginia in 1799. He was born into slavery and belonged to the family of Peter Blow. In 1830, the Blow family moved to the slave state of Missouri. However, by 1834, the family had fallen on hard times. Mr. Scott was subsequently sold to Dr. John Emerson, a surgeon in the United States Army. As a soldier, Dr. Emerson moved around a lot. He took Scott with him to Illinois and Fort Snelling, which is now in the state of Minnesota. Both Illinois and Fort Snelling were free states under the Missouri Compromise of 1820. While at Fort Snelling, Scott met another slave, Harriet Robinson, and Dr. Emerson allowed them to get married. When Dr. Emerson moved his family back to Missouri in 1838, he took the Scotts with him.
That's a lot of moving.
Are you keeping up?
Yes, barely.
Oh, good. Let's keep moving. The Scotts gave birth to two daughters, Eliza and Lizzie. Then, in 1843, Dr. Emerson died, leaving all his possessions to his widow, Irene. Irene began hiring out the Scotts to other nearby families in the St. Louis area. By 1846, Dred Scott had had enough. He asked Mrs. Emerson if he could work for money to buy his family's freedom. Mrs. Emerson refused, so Scott filed a lawsuit against her.
Could he do that?
Legally, yes. Financially, well, no. However, his original owners, the Blow family, agreed to pay for his lawsuit.
That was nice of them. What was his argument? That slavery was terrible?
It was a little more complicated than that. Scott sued Mrs. Emerson for false imprisonment and battery. He claimed that he had become a free man as soon as he lived in a free state or territory. Remember, Illinois and Fort Snelling were both considered free land. Therefore, he argued that he should not have been returned to slavery when he moved back to the slave state of Missouri. This was a common argument at the time. Slaves who had been taken to free land were suing their masters and winning their freedom. The doctrine was called once free, always free.
So, did he win?
Well, the case lasted 11 years.
11 years? That's like forever.
I'm sure it seemed that way sometimes to the Scott family.
Why did it take so long? It seems pretty simple to me.
Well, in 1847, Mrs. Emerson won the first round on a technicality.
How so?
Scott's lawyers failed to prove to the jury that Scott and his family were owned by Mrs. Emerson.
That's weird.
But in 1850, Scott's lawyers successfully argued for a retrial. This time, Scott won. Dred, Harriet, and their daughters were all freed from slavery.
Terrific. End of story?
Nope. Mrs. Emerson, who was now living in Massachusetts, left her brother, John Sanford, in charge of her financial affairs. Acting for his sister, Sanford appealed to the Missouri Supreme Court, where in 1852, two of the three judges found in favor of Mr. Sanford and Mrs. Emerson. So, the Scott family were not free again.
Ridiculous!
By 1853, Sanford had moved to New York, leaving the Scotts in Missouri. Because the parties now lived in different states, Dred Scott was able to take his case to federal court. Unfortunately, in 1854, the federal court followed the opinion of the Missouri Supreme Court, so the Scott family remained not free.
I sure hope this case had a happy ending.
It was a difficult time. The United States was very divided on the subject of slavery. Under the Missouri Compromise, Missouri had been admitted to the United States as a slave state, while Maine was admitted as a free state. This compromise was an attempt to maintain the delicate balance which was holding the United States together. Then, the Kansas-Nebraska Act of 1854 had established local choice regarding slavery in Kansas and Nebraska, despite the fact that both states were located north of the already established compromise line. The issues were real and ready to boil. So, when Dred Scott appealed to the United States Supreme Court, everyone was watching. It's important to note that 5 of the 9 Supreme Court justices were slaveholders themselves. In fact, Justice Peter V. Daniel from Virginia supported slavery so much that he refused to travel north into a free state.
Really? That seems a little unfair.
Not surprisingly, the court ruled 7-2 in favor of Samford. Dred Scott had been trying for 11 years in court to free his family from the chains of slavery, and he was finally given a firm no.
What was the court's reasoning?
The court ruled that Scott, a slave, could never achieve U.S. citizenship, and therefore could not sue in federal court.
I see.
It should have ended there. However, the court also tried to settle the issue of slavery. They ruled that the Missouri Compromise of 1820 was unconstitutional, which left the question of slavery to the individual states rather than to the federal government. As a result, tension increased between the northern and southern states. The New York Tribune explained the situation in this way.
Now, wherever the stars and stripes wave, they protect slavery and represent slavery. The black and cursed stain is thick on our hands.
Citizens on both sides of the slavery issue were outraged, ultimately leading to the bloodiest conflict in our nation's history, the Civil War.
Wow, that was a bad decision.
Maybe the worst. It was a classic example of the Supreme Court trying to impose a judicial solution on a political problem, and it backfired.
Big time.
Well, how about some good news?
Yes, certainly.
Okay. Shortly after the case ended, Mrs. Emerson remarried, and because her new husband opposed slavery, she gave the Scott family back to the Blow family, Dred's original owner.
Okay.
And the Blow family gave Dred, Harriet, Eliza, and Lizzie their freedom. Dred Scott then took a job as a porter at Barnum's Hotel in St. Louis, where he became a bit of a celebrity, earning his own money as a free man.
That's awesome. I love a happy ending. What else can we learn about today?
It's up to them. What would you like to learn about next?